Two nights have I watched with you, but can perceive no truth in your report. When was it she last walked?
Since his majesty went into the field. I have seen her rise from her bed, throw her nightgown upon her. Unlock her closet. Take forth paper. Fold it. Write upon it. Read it. Afterwards seal it, and again return to bed, yet all this while in a most fast sleep.
What at any time have you heard her say?
That, sir, which I will not report after her.
Nay, to me, 'tis most meet you should.
No, you. Here she comes. This is her very guise, and upon my life, fast asleep. Observe her, stand close.
How came she by that light?
Why, it stood by her. She has light by her continually, 'tis her command.
See, her eyes are open.
Aye, but their sense are shut.
What is it she does now? Look how she rubs her hands.
It is an accustomed action with her to seem thus washing her hands. I have known her continue in this quarter of an hour.
Yet here's a spot.
Hark, she speaks.
Out, damn spot. Out, I say. One, two. Why, then, 'tis time to do it. Hell is murky. Fie, my lord, fie, a soldier and a feared. What need we fear who knows it when none can call our power into account? Yet who would have thought the old man to have so much blood in him?
Do you mark that?
The Thane of Fife had a wife. Where is she now? What? Will these hands ne'er be clean? No more that, my lord, no more that. You mar all with this starting.
Don't you, you have known what you should not.
She has spoke what she should not, I am sure of that. Heaven knows what she has known.
Here's the smell of the blood still. All the perfumes of Arabia will not sweeten this little hand. No.
Is there? The heart is sorely charged.
I have not such a heart in my bosom for the dignity of the whole body.
This disease is beyond my practice.
Wash your hands. Get on your nightgown. Look not so pale. I tell you yet again, Drake was buried. He cannot come out on his grave.
So.
To bed. To bed. There's a knocking at the gate. Come. Give me your hand. What's done cannot be undone. To bed.
Will she now go to bed?
Directly.
Foul whisperings are abroad. Natural deeds do breed unnatural troubles. Infected minds to their deaf spirits will discharge their secrets. More needs she the divine than the physician. God forgive us all. Look after her. Remove from her the means of all annoyance and still keep eyes upon her. So good night. My mind, she has made it and amazed my sight. I think but dare not speak.
Good night, good doctor.
The English power is near, led on by Malcolm, the Thane of Ross, and the good Macduff. Revenge is burning them. For the dear causes would to the bleeding and grim alarm excite the mortified man.
Near Burnham Wood shall we well meet
them. Who knows if Dunobain be with his brother?
For certain, sir, he is not.
What does the
tyrant? Great Dunsinane strongly fortifies. Some say he's mad. Others, the lesser, hate him. Do call it valiant fury.
Now does he feel his secret murder sticking on his hands. Now minutely revolts upbraid his faith breach. Those he commands move only in command, nothing in love. Now does he feel his title hang loose about him, like a giant's robe upon a dwarfish thief.
Well, march we on to give obedience where 'tis really owed.
Make we our march towards Burnham!
Burnham!
Let them fly all. To Burnham Wood come to Dunsinane, I cannot taint with fear. What's the boy Malcolm? Was he not born of woman? The spirits that know all mortal consequences have pronounced me thus. Fear not, Macbeth. No man that's born of woman shall e'er have power upon thee. Then fly, false thanes, and mingle with the English epicures. The mind I sway by and the heart I bear shall never sag with doubt, nor shake with fear. devil, damn thee black, thou cream-faced loon. Where gotst thou thy goose look?
There is 10,000.
Geese ridden
soldiers, sir.
Go prick thy face and overread thy fear, thou lily-livered boy. What soldiers, Patch? Those linen cheeks of thine are counselors to fear. What soldiers, Wayface?
The English force, so please you.
Take thy face hence. Satan, I am sick at heart when I behold such. Satan, I say! This push will cheer me ever, or deceit me now. I have lived long enough. My way of life has fallen into the sear. Satan!
What is your gracious pleasure?
What news more?
All is confirmed, my lord, which was reported.
I'll fight till from my bones my flesh be hacked. Bring me mine armor.
'Tis not needed.
I'll put it on. Send up more horses. Skirt the country round. Hang those that talk of fear. Give me mine armor. How does your patient, doctor?
Not so sick, my lord, as she is troubled by thick coming fancies that keep her from her rest.
Cure her of that. Canst thou not minister to a mind disease? Pluck from the memory a rooted sorrow, raise out the written troubles of the brain, and with some sweet, oblivious antidote, cleanse the stuffed bosom of that perilous stuff which weighs upon the heart?
Therein the patient must minister to himself.
Throw physic to the dog, I'll none of it. Come, put on mine armor. Satan, send out, give me my sword. Comes her dispatch. If thou couldst, doctor, cast the water of my land, find her disease, purge it to a sound and pristine health, I would applaud thee to the very echo that should applaud again. Pull it off, I say. Bring it after me. I will not be afraid of death and bane till Burnham Forest come to Dunsinane.
Cousins, I hope the days are near at hand that Chambers will be safe.
We doubt it nothing.
What wood is this before us?
The wood of Burnham.
Let every soldier hew him down a bough and bear it before him. Thereby shall we shadow the numbers of our host and make discovery ere and report of us.
It shall be done.
Let our just censors attend the true event, and put we on industrious soldiership.
The time approaches that will with due decision make us know what we shall say we have and what we owe. Not speculative their unsure hopes relate, but certain issue strokes must arbitrate, towards which advance the war!
Advance the war! Advance the war!
Hang out our banners on the outward walls. The cry is still, they come. Our castle's strength will laugh a siege to scorn. Here let the blight of famine and the ague eat them up. What is that noise? Wherefore was that cry?
The queen, my lord, is dead.
She should have died hereafter. There would have been time for such a word. Tomorrow, and tomorrow, and tomorrow creeps in this petty pace from day to the last syllable of recorded time. And all our yesterdays have lighted fools way to dusty death. Out, out, brief candle. Life's but a walking shadow, a poor player that struts and frets his hour upon the stage and then is heard no more. It is a tale told by an idiot, full of sound and fury, signifying nothing. Thou comest to use thy tongue, thy story quickly.
Gracious my lord, I should report that which I say I saw, but know not how to do it.
Well, say, sir.
As I did stand my watch upon the hill, I looked toward Burnham, and anon methought the wood began to move.
Liar and slave!
Let me endure your wrath if it be not so. Within this 3 mile may you see it coming, I say, a moving grove.
If this which you say proves false upon the first tree, shall thou hang alive till famine cling thee. Fear not, so Burnham Wood come to Dunsinane, and now a wood come towards Dunsinane. On and out! If we hereabouts proves true, there's no flying hence or tarrying here. I begin to be weary of the sun, and wish the estate of the world were now undone. Ring the alarm bell! Blow wind! Come rack! At least we'll die with harness on our back!
No! Fear enough! Your leafy screen throw down and show like those you are!
Do we but find the tyrant's power tonight? Let us be beaten if we cannot fight!
They have tied me to a stake. I cannot fly, but bear like I will fight the cause. What's he that's not born of woman? Such a one I am to fear or none.
What is thy name?
Thou be afraid to hear it.
No, though thou callest thyself a hotter name than any is in hell.
My name's Macbeth.
The devil himself could not pronounce a title more hateful to mine ear.
No. No.
Thou liest! Abhorrent tyrant! With my sword I'll prove the lie thou speakest!
But swords I smile at! Weapons laughed to scorn, brandished by a man that's of woman born!
Stroke of mine. My wife and children's ghosts will haunt me still. Either thou, Macbeth, or else my sword with an unbattered edge I sheathe again undeeded. Fortune, let me find him, and more I may not!
Make all our trumpets speak! Give them all breath! Those clamorous harbingers of blood and death!
Why should I die on my own sword? While I see lives, the gashes do better upon them.
Turn! Hellhound! Turn!
Of all men else, I have avoided thee. But get thee back. My soul is too charged with the blood of thine already.
I have no words. My voice is in my sword.
Then let thy blade fall on vulnerable crests, for I bear a charmed life, which must not yield to one of woman born.
Then despair thy charm. And let the angel whom thou still hast served tell thee that Macduff was from his mother's womb untimely ripped.
Accursed be the tongue that tells me so, for it hath cowed my better part of man. I will not fight with thee.
Then yield thee, coward, and live to be the gaze and show o' the time. We'll have thee, as our rarer monsters are, painted upon a pole and underwrit. Here may you see the tyrant!
I will not yield to kiss the ground before young Malcolm's feet, or to be baited with the rabble's curse. Though Burnham would come to Dunsinane, and thou opposed, being of no woman born, yet I will try the last.
Enough!
king. For so thou art. The time is free.
Hail, King of Scotland!
Hail, King of Scotland!
We shall not spend a large expense of time. What's more to do, as would be newly planted with the time, as calling home our exiled friends abroad, that fled the snares of watchful tyranny, producing forth the cruel ministers of this dead butcher, and his fiend-like queen, who as 'tis thought, by self and violent hands took off her life. This, and what needful else that calls upon us, by the grace of grace, we will perform in measure, time, and place.
Hail, King of Scotland!